Ja, ich bin wieder allein.
All right, I'm once again on my own. I'm even more nervous in front of so many people.
Gut. Also, wir beteiligen uns aktiv an den Diskussionen. Das ist ein Zitat.
We're actively engaged in the discussion. Is a citation from the Digital Agenda 2014 to 2017. Of the positions. I wrote agenda in quotation marks. There's a reason for that. I'll get to that later. And I'll talk about it from a philological, linguistic, and also content point of view. There's also something new there right away. And from now, I've been more coming from a linguistic angle, but I'm also a philologue. Let's think about what that actually is. It's here it is in Greek. It is the friendship with words. It's more precisely the science of the texts, the content. Even more Mathe, fantastic. That's even Flora. All right, the knowledge of the texts. This is also an area, one of my areas. It counts very dry. And the politicians think we can just cut it. And that's what's currently happening in Saarbrücken University. We really don't want that. So I want to show why philology is something very, very recent and which you can really use even in a political context. And I will show that using the digital agenda. So first I'll talk about philology and then I'll talk about digital agenda. And then finally, for those who still make it, I have some citations from politicians. All right, how do you do philology? Once upon a time, you used cards. So, for example, the Italian Atlas with 5 million cards that you have to manually search. Nowadays, you use IT. For example, I use the Path National Language Toolkit, which I heartily recommend, with which you can do a lot more than what I just show. Most of the things that I can do, you can do with regular expressions and a text editor. You can even do a lot more than I did. That will be the future. So there are different sub-areas in philology. It's very old. And because it's so old, these areas have Latin names. And it's pretty easy to recognize. You just need to attach an N. So traditio, critica, interpretatio. What does this mean? What is traditio? It's about to reconstructing the text. And it's called tradition, and which is, looks like handwritten text, and you can hardly read, and then someone tries to transliterate it into a legible text. Here's a text from Wallenstein, from the 17th century, and this is re-represented in a digital form, is legible. You can do it even today, so if you want, you can immediately work on the Wallenstein text using Wikisource. Let me do some advertisement right away. So here it is, you can do it on Wikisource. So this is modern philology, particularly this area of traditio. You wonder, well, what has this got to do with the digital agenda? This doesn't exist in a handwritten form, but it actually is handwritten because there is a so-called PDF.
So the PDF is just as bad as a handwritten. And we can see here the title page of the digital agenda. And you're still laughing, but right, we'll have to liberate PDFs, and especially this PDF is very full of things. And there's a PDF to text tool that has been made for blind people, and the blind people really have a hard time. And in this PDF, the problem is because the umlauts are encoded differently, and hyphens and dashes are mixed up, and there are hard line breaks, sometimes inside a word. And there are abbreviations and some blank spaces between them, and sometimes none at all. And if you liberate it, you have to convert that. And for the work on the PDF, it has taken about as much time as the rest of the preparations of the talk, and so about a day and a half. So And I kept some things, and here's a diplomatic edition, and has nothing to do with diplomacy, but it's about the diploma. And if we do it the same way as it says in the diploma, that's the diplomatic edition, and what I kept was is the things that diverted from the norm, and for example, there's the idiot's blank space, there's the best effort internet, and these, if you want to know where the sources are, and there, the idiot's blank spaces are always in the parts about economy. So you can find out where it comes from originally.
And
we will see now, or we'll see later in the security, and the same word is spelled differently, and we can see that later, and I kept that here. And we always wanted to have a machine-readable government. If you remember that, there was the machine-readable ID card, and people in the vicinity of the CCC said, we want a machine-readable government. And what did we get? And we get PDF. And I could have said WTF. And I was really annoyed by this PDF. And I wonder, because in the text there's something different. There's the first example from the Digital Agenda. There's by open data, the machine-readable opening of government data, and we will improve the transparency and have more and supply more digital services. And now there's the second part of the philology, that is Kritika, and we have trees with Greek letters. These are the different versions or the different editions. And this is an invented tree. And in this one is about a text which has different sources, perhaps only fragmentary sources. These are alpha and beta. And there's a first common version that is gamma, and maybe that doesn't exist, but we can reconstruct it. And alpha is a bit older than beta, and we reconstruct gamma, which is the original edition. Then there is a second version, epsilon, and zeta, a third one, and maybe also a fourth version, eta, and we can liken it to versions in a versioning system. There's beta 1 and beta 2, and there's the version 1.0, and there's the final release is the 1.1, and maybe later on there's version 2. And of course, there's things like forks, and of course, here wrong ways and forks, and some people think forks are wrong, and some forks are wrong, and it's a kind of ideology which you think is correct and which is a bad fork. And here we have the original edition, if we have the reconstructed version, or we have the final edition. If we want to find out on which edition the original author worked last time. And we can derive it from these. And here we see the tree for the digital agenda. And there are three ministries have been working on that. Those are alpha, beta, and gamma. And they are not really there because they are stars. We don't have those versions. That's the input. And then we have the first common draft that is delta and has been leaked. So we know it. We know about it, but it has been leaked by Netzpolitik. So thank you very much to Netzpolitik. That's why we have this leaked first draft. On the 9th of July 2014, and there is the Ressort harmonized draft, which is sort of public, and it can be seen at Netzpolitik as HTML. There's Epsilon Prime, and then there was the version 1.0. It has been reconstructed by me and has been released as a PDF, as a final version 1.0. And from the PDF, I have reconstructed Epsilon Dash and reconstructed the Zeta and also uploaded it. And you can find here for download, and you can run on the script, can run your scripts on the text version, which I have made, and I have made a markup version. And you can make ebooks from that, whatever you want. And I have reconstructed this from the PDF that has been released. And that's what you would like from a government, really. And PDF is an error, and you can see that, or a mistake, and you can see that by the journalists who talked about it, who reported about it, as far as I know, and I have been interviewed by Broadband, and the link that I was given was the HTML from Netzpolitik and not from the original PDF. And because with a PDF, you have to read 40 pages. And anyone has read the PDF here in the audience? Anyone has read the entire PDF? So, yeah, one has read the entire PDF. So very few only. And most people have searched in it in the HTML version on Netzpolitik. And the versions are not quite identical. There are about a dozen small changes. There are 23 changes, but some are just quotation marks or something like that. I didn't count that. Sorry, about a wrong quotation marks, which have been corrected. But there's about a dozen changes in the text. And these changes in the text are mostly not very interesting, but some are. And here's an example. In the last moment, something has been edited. Some of the journalists didn't see because they used the HTML version, and that was fine to do that. So there's version 0.9, and we can see we will improve the
availability of mobile internet or Wi-Fi. Therefore, we will work on digital security for the providers of these Wi-Fis in the official areas, for example, on airports, hotels, cafeterias, for example. Basically, these is not intended for violating the right. These people should not be made responsible for what their customers do. We will offer, or we will in legal.
So basically, they shouldn't be held responsible for that. In colloquially, you said that's just the way it is. But in legal terms, if it says basically, then there may be cases in which they can be held responsible. So it means something as normally, yeah, but sometimes there are exceptions, and we will see some of those exceptions later because there's an improvement of the improvement. So it's really making things worse. So that was a difference in version 1.0. There's an addition, and we will make sure that the IT security is guaranteed, and there will be no new open gates for anonymous criminality or criminal actions, and which means that the have to be shown IDs for allowing access to that, and then we can see what this basically means if. They don't make sure that they know about everyone using the internet and get ID from everyone using this access, then they may be held responsible for that. And this was a big change in that many people haven't found because they didn't look at the PDF. And now we go to the interpretation, the interpretatio, and that means making incomprehensible stuff understandable. It was created in Rome because people had Greek texts and couldn't understand that. It was old Greek, ancient Greek, and people couldn't understand that and had to be interpreted. And that's the way we have to do with the digital agenda as well. And we use a certain technology that's called hermeneutics. Hermeneuin in Greek is interpret and explain. And there are ways and methods since the old times how you can do that. And normally you assume that there's a coherent and consistent text, and with the digital agenda that's a problem, but we don't have to take that quite as literally, because originally people did that with holy scriptures, and those are usually even less coherent. And the way it works is we have some previous knowledge, and we gain new knowledge. And now we have new knowledge, and with new knowledge, we look at the text and gain some
new insight.
Further knowledge, some further insight. And so we get more and more insight, and people who critique this one say that if you go there with previous knowledge, you also go there with prejudice. But you can really disarm that critique because we always have previous knowledge. We cannot just empty our heads. But what we can do is we can exclude prejudice by a certain way in approaching the text, because for example, by looking at very frequent words or keywords, and then we have to define what keywords are and how you get the keywords. But then you can use quantitative methods and really substantiate this and just don't use a free interpretation. But there's an insight that came from hermeneutics, And if there is a coherent and consistent text, which we assume, then it doesn't matter where we start. Then the insight that we gain from this text, from little parts of the text, as well as in the whole text, and so we don't have to look at every page of the text, we can look at certain points, and what we see there, what we find out there, has to be coherent with the entire text. And we can even go to a level which is smaller than a word, and I will do that. And I look at words, and then I look at fragments of words, parts of words, and then we will look at the whole, and then we'll see there's a convergence of the insight.
Agenda, the word, is the Latin word agere, doing something, and there's the word active in it. When we're talking about an agenda, we have to talk about being active. You see it in the headline of my talk. The word active is very frequent in that text. 13 times, actually.
Bei solchen Texten ist halt so, weil da natürlich auch viele Funktionswörter drin sind.
In these texts, there are many functional words.
Zweistelliger Bereich, immer schon.
So a two-digit number says something about these words being representative. 13 times this word comes up. Proactive is coming up one time.
Also irgendwie schon aktiv, bevor die anderen.
So it's being active before being active. We will see it in the context.
Das klingt ja gut.
Also sounds good, doesn't it? Agenda, being active, goes together well. We're all really happy with that. So government seems to be active.
Fast alle Belege, 12 von 13 vor. Der eine.
Now I give you some examples. Nearly all 13 of them. And I will show them. And you will see. And you will see that the word active is actually never being actually meant. The government will push forward this development and will campaign it actively. So it's the politics job to actively accompany the structural change. We will accompany actively the discussion process in VN, Human Rights Council. We will
accompany discussions in the International Telecommunications Union discussions, continue to actively accompany them, including discussions to digital areas in the OECD things, we will actively co-create them. This is a weakening of the active word. And finally, we have actively collaborate. So we increase and then decrease the power of it. We call it baton in Greek. And it has a weird effect on the reader, because if we made it negative, there will be inactively support. That wouldn't make sense. Let's continue. Furthermore, we will allow the exercise of rights for European states and will support them in exercising their rights. We are actively engaged in discussions with the ICANN, in discussions with the reorganization and control of IP and general internet resources.
Also wir wirken mit.
To summarize, we are actively engaged. And we continue. We accompany the current processes actively. We will actively participate in the preparations for the UE Commission. We can see that the activity is not really an activity. We are actively engaged and with the discussions of the continuing process to the etc., etc. So we always have this active, but the accompanying verb of accompanying and doesn't really work. Finally, proactive. Finally, to move forward the debate, the expert dialogue neutrality, we will develop and continue, and all participants will be included proactively. Well. Again, participants participate. Why is it now proactive? doesn't mean anything.
Aber Agenda.
But Agenda. Active. Irgendjemand
muss doch jetzt aktiv werden.
Finally, ja, I think we have to be active now. Finally, someone does become active, but it's not the point. The government will support the citizens in becoming active for their co-citizens. Ah, great. The citizens are becoming active.
Ah, es werden noch mehr aktiv.
Ah, more people becoming active. We want that every single person securely informs themselves and actively participates in digital society, except for the government, of course. Digital agenda? Really? No. Agenda does not fit the bill at all. It's better to call it digital patienda. I.e. to suffer the suffering, digital suffering. That, I think that fits it, the bill better. Now something happens. There are financial means. There are so three areas from the digital rendite, frequencies are being sold once again, and therefore you get money and something you do something with it. And clearly, they first talked with the financial minister and gave every person, allowed every single area to spend money once. Not additional money, but the money from this frequency sale. And now you can guess what they suggested. It's written in the digital agenda, maybe not everyone remembers. Virtual economy suggested.
Wir richten hierzu aus unseren Mitteln einen Modernitätsfonds ein.
We will create a modernity fund pool with which we will promote good ideas from the young generations. So infrastructure. I remember this is the Mount Minister Dobrindt from the CSU. What can he? What might he suggest? I'm hearing the email. Yeah, that sounds good. Yeah. Well, that's not the infrastructure minister. You have to remember that Bavaria is a country area, so he wants money for the country. So, supply in the county areas with state means we will support there where it is not not financially viable in the country areas. So now we sell frequencies, and now people can use the frequencies to use the social habitat, and now they get money back, and it doesn't make a lot of sense. Ah, Interior, Ministry of Interior, that's easy.
Yeah, klar.
Of course, security. We will improve the personal and material equipment of the security entities. This is the only place where they are more specific. Right, more specific. We will expand the cybercrime center in the Bundeskriminalamt, the national crime center.
Wir stärken das Bundesamt für Verfassungsschutz.
We will improve the Verfassungsschutz, the Interior Secret Service, strategically and organizationally, in order to prepare them to with changes that terrorists and extremists might make in their communications. In order to do this, we will allow them, the Verfassungsschutz, a topic suited infrastructure and analysis tools to improve the use of data and communication tools. All right, we see that we are spending money for people who we'll use it. All right, who will fix it if there is no money? Well, there is an interesting strategy here. You can guess who might have to fix it if the government doesn't have the money. Of course, the market. 23 times it comes up. And there's a completely new word which is being created in the digital agenda, which I find very interesting. The expansion of the infrastructure should be driven by the market, which is to say, support of the market-driven expansion. So in order to say where there's money, the market will drive it, and where there's no money, we will add money. All right. If we don't have any more ideas, we do support and demand, or plead and promote. Paragraph
2.
So this phrase is a bit burned currently. So the unemployed people must be forced to do something, and the more active people get the support. So this phrase is not long used any longer, so they improved it slightly. So still the same slogan, but
und das Innenministerium in seinem Abschnitt macht sich das.
So the Ministry of Inner Affairs now takes this phrase, and they take over this phrase. So we want and support simple security technology, connecting people with the internet. People connecting people with the internet have to be responsible for to make sure that the people can use the network securely. There's high level or high demand for privacy and security, and it's improving
And finally, we support and demand the improvement of IT technologies in order to improve encryption and in the electronic communication means. This leads to a strengthening of the market for IT. Finally, we don't just talk about complete sentences, but we also look at small pieces. For example, words starting IT or IKT. IKT stands for Information and Communication Technology. On the other hand, cyber. Okay. The difference is obvious. I'm not quite sure what cyber means, but is the one thing is neutral, the other thing is evil. I will show you using some example. So 67 times IT or IKT, 23 times cyber. Cyber with the combination, thus the ellipsis. So here's some examples. Cyber crime, cyber espionage, cyber attacks. Evil things. Cyber space. Sounds neutral, but is not meant in a neutral way. More security in the cyberspace. Oh, it's unsafe, so it needs to be secured. So once again, then cybercrime, cyber espionage, cybersecurity, English and German mixed. So cyber espionage is written together here as opposed to above. So it's written in a different way, in the same page. Cyber arms race. Cyber security, obvious.
Und Cyberkapazitätsaufbau.
And Cyberkapazitätsaufbau or Cyber Capacity Building.
Das klang so komisch, dass
it sounded so weird that they had to add the English after it.
Ja.
Well.
Jetzt aber mal zur digitalen Agenda.
All right. Back to the digital agenda top down. What is it in summary? And what are the pieces? 36 pages PDF. About 27 sides. 36 pages is a lot, but there's a lot of empty space. 11,000 words, about 88,000 symbols.
Aufbau, Präambel.
So here's the structure, preamble, the fundamental pieces of our digital politics, the means, seven actions, and they are divided up into several sub-areas. I have colored it in. So infrastructure is Dobrindt in blue, economy is in red, and then three times interior ministry, so in yellow.
Das habe ich mir nicht so ausgedacht, sondern das sagt de Maizière.
That's what the Minister de Maizière says.
Und dann gibt's noch andere Ressourcen,
and there's other areas which are not really well connected, but are added ad hoc, for example, media, science, and European collaboration. As we can see, interior security is the most important part. And digital infrastructure, but just the one action. Even in the Wikipedia says that digital agenda is mainly a broadband expansion. That's not really the case. All right, first, the government avows itself to the necessity of covering broadband areas. If anyone has heard the podcast Nordhörspunkt, we analyzed that this avowing to is always used if you really don't want to do anything about it.
Yeah.
Right.
So, okay, so the availability of high-performance broadband networks, and they are the premises for equal means of participating in the digital society, in these broadband networks. And it continues. And the basics, the fundamentals, the foundations for the participations should already be created in the education of our children. Should they learn to crimp cables so they can lay the cables, or what does that mean? So the connection is completely unclear. So what's this about? And this means, this shows that maybe it's a good sign for that really nobody knows what they should write, and there's a big insecurity about that. And we will see that a couple of times. And the most frequent words, and we can see that, we already know that already, talked about it there, the most common particle is we, the pronoun is we and us, that's 351 times, so it's just after the functional particles and the, and so very often the we feeling, because we is the government and they do it for our country and things like that, so we, most frequent content words is digital, and digitizations, things like that, economy, and digital is only 2 points, because there's digital and the inflected forms in the German. And if it was language, it's digitized, and then economy, Germany, and security. And we can see what it's about, and economy and security are the most important players here. The longest word is the wonderful word. It's one I found. It has something to do with economy, as you could have guessed. It's really impressive. It's called Gesundheitswirtschaftsunternehmen. That is a business in the healthcare industry. It's one of these long German words. It has 33 letters. It's the longest word. It's about in the healthcare industry. Okay, so about the political, and I already gave a verdict that was negative, and now here's the final political verdict, and before I do that, I let the responsible people talk, and their short quotations of the presentation of the digital agenda, and then there will be a comprehensive verdict, and we do that in philosophy, and it's called recension research, and that's what I do, and we do that. We let the responsible people get their say, and there is that's really on their cheat sheets. And the last one is from de Maizière and Dobrindt, and they were spontaneous, and I won't judge them too harshly, because it was unprepared. But now there's a prepared statement from de Maizière about security, first by de Maizière, about security. And we can see those on the right side is the moderator, and there are the three ministers, and we will listen to that. And certification, we want also the email. And did you understand a word of it? And I understood we want the email, but what he wants is die E-Mail, is this special German die E-Mail, and the certification, and we also want die E-Mail with full coverage and secure, and this is a secure method, and an email is like a postcard, and with die E-Mail we make an email at least as secure as a letter. And we also need this federal states. So there's more security with Demisier, and I don't think I need to comment that any further. And yeah, more secure than a letter. Well, but there's more about security. Don't think that's everything. So, and we will achieve, and I'm curious to see the recommendations. And we also have protections against crime, and there is no of the, there's no digital world that is separate from the analog world, and the human is always responsible, and the internet is not a lawless space, and there are punishable crimes in the internet and outside the internet, and therefore the protection from crime is, and the search for the criminals is a job inside the net and outside the net, and there are special conditions because of the net, that's clear.
And
there are certain conditions because of the net, that's clear. All right, yeah. That was, of course, we all know it, and the net is not a lawless space, and of course, yes. So there's the wordsmith Dobrindt. Pfeffer said yesterday it's not his word, so let's listen very carefully. There's a word at the end. And I don't have any proof except Dobrindt. Maybe someone can find prior proof. Maybe he didn't think of it himself. And here he is. He reminds me of and I asked people, who does he remind him of? And I thought a bit Otto Walkes and maybe Kermit the Frog. Oh, well, Alexander Dobrindt. The Maut Minister. And it shows that all the discussions show that we had in the last months and weeks in the question, how does the economy develop in our country and how does the society develop in our country? And all of this only works on the basis well-maintained and well-built infrastructure, because by the constantly increasing data, we have to be able to create economy from this data by processing this data accordingly, and we are standing in front of a data tsunami. There's the data tsunami, and so, what is that? Well, that's the word that I've, the data tsunami. And, and now in this conference here, there's a possibility to ask questions in that press conference. And there was a Falk Steiner, maybe known to some, and he asks, maybe it's NSA and things like that. What about surveillance? And surveillance doesn't even play a role in this text. And why is that? And now the politicians have to speak freely. And at first we have Demisier, who explains why surveillance doesn't appear. The word surveillance doesn't appear because we didn't use it. Well, yeah, there's nothing you could say about that.
Also, Überwachung,
okay, surveillance, and we hear it in a different way. The word surveillance, you won't find it here because we don't use it, but on page 33 you will find of the digital agenda under more security in cyberspace, and there are guidelines for the Bundeskriminalamt and for the Interior Secret Service, and we find it very important to increase protection of the economy for the middle state, and we need to talk about technical protections against crime, and this is not surveillance, and surveillance is an attack word, a military word that shall not be used here in the digital agenda, and it shall not be conflated with the normal things that we need to do to protect us from criminals. So now the question to Dobrindt. The TÜV estimated 20 to 25 billion euros for the broadband. Very precise. 20 to 95 billion euros. And how much of that is the federal government going to pay? And, well, they don't want to pay anything, but Dobrindt, of course, cannot say that, and he really doesn't want to say any number. And it's hard for him, I admit that, but it's interesting to see how he avoids how he avoids answering the question. Broadband is on different levels possible. Is and a frequency for the government is much easier than glass fiber, and in the Network Alliance we ask the companies to calculate that, and in October we will have precise numbers which in investment Germany has to do, and there are still substantial investments of the economy, this of the business and of the enterprises. And if we talk about 20 billion, and if someone says 20 billion, then everybody has to say what is his share about that. And then we know the economy gap, which has to be closed by our funding programs. Well, okay. Now everybody knows how that works, right? And we tell them we sell frequencies about 700 megahertz, and we auction them off for you. And of course, not so many people want it. There's not a big demand. They have to buy it. But we do that. And if you buy that, and then you can make broadband from that and sell it back to us, and then you get money back from us. So that's a game. It goes, and with these schemes, somebody has to pay in the end, as it always is with these schemes. And if there's internet by radio, and there are volume restrictions, and so the customer is going to pay. And that's not a very good idea to improve the broadband the way he wants to. And only the digital dividend is being paid out from the digital frequency sales. And so to summarize the digital patienda, the broadband expansion is market-driven, as I explained. And we talk about analog values, and we have to respect the analog values in the nets, such as copyright, and there's security and more surveillance. And the text always talks about trust. It doesn't talk about surveillance, only about trust. We have to create trust in the security of the net. So for the Interior Secret Service and the Criminal Office, and there's the lip service about open data, but nothing has been done. And there's a lot of fear, uncertainty, and doubt. And not only we shall see that, or get the impression that there is more security and in the cyberspace. And some of the responsible people maybe think that by themselves, and even we can see that by them talking about the data tsunami, and we can assume that for Dobrindt the internet really is this data tsunami. And so it's clear our interests are not part of the digital agenda, but unlike the federal government, we can become active and do things about it. But again, and this data, these PDFs, we can liberate them, as Netzpolitik has done. And you keep asking how this federal government can, without Netzpolitik and Open Foundation, can even free data at all without the works of Netzpolitik and others. And we can do that, and we can become active. And at least I think some parties just shouldn't be elected anymore. But neither should others, but certain ones especially not.
Yeah.
Okay. As I said, my call.
Don't stay passive. Become active. Join the CCC. I think that with these people, that we are far superior than the people doing the digital agenda. So thanks a lot.
Yeah, sicher.
So questions?
Kommen wir zu einer Viertelstunde Q&A. Das ist ganz schön viel.
Quarter of an hour Q&A. That's quite a lot, so please hear up at the microphones. So if you have a question, and if you don't have a question, please simply make up some.
Signal Angels, sind die da?
Are Signal Angels available? Do they have questions?
Currently one from the IRC. If philologs could have one a wish,
so which format, which exchange format would they like to have? As I said, I showed that your text data is good, Markdown is good, because you can make everything from Markdown, so there's a syntax you...
den reinen Text und kann damit eben auch Auswertungen machen. Man kann die übrigens auch oft mit dem Markdown machen, denn der Markdown ist für diese Python-Tools meistens...
So Markdown is for Python-Tools quite neutral, except the underscore, but it's just handled quite differently. But you can replace the underscore with the asterisk. Markdown is quite fine, I think. You can make everything from it. I read the digital agenda again as an EPUB in PUB 3 format. You can jump everywhere, you can code everything. It's quite good. And I like PUB 3 the most. First you have to use Markdown, then you use Pandoc to convert it to the format you really want to have. But text without anything in UTF-8 is quite fine as well.
Mikrofon 2, bitte.
Okay, Mikrofon 2.
Ja, aktiv okay, werden,
get active, Forum, become active, wonderful, really great. But some examples of how you can get active. For example, think, couldn't you think how philologically or maybe legally look at the constitution where there is the right for resistance? Maybe that's worthwhile.
There are commentaries about what is really actually meant in the Grundgesetz. So it's quite difficult. We shouldn't go that far.
Vielleicht reißt das hier nicht jeden vom Hocker.
Maybe it's not making everyone happy, but there are a couple of ways where you can start working. The audience knows already.
In der Kirche, wo dann auch immer gesagt wird, oh, ihr kommt in die Hölle, aber die, die da sind,
it's preaching to the converted.
Preaching to the choir.
Also von daher, ich meine, hier wissen alle, dass man E-Mail-Verschlüsselung
durchführen kann. Everyone knows that you should encrypt your emails, that you should use open formats.
Freie Software.
Free software. Das muss man ja nicht sagen. I don't have to tell you that.
Eben auch dazu. Und dann soll man eben
part of that. Die Leute
sozusagen missionieren,
so you should go out and preach to the people who have not been converted right currently to make this idea being supported by the public.
Wir wollen ja auch zu anderen sprechen.
So we want to talk to others, not our internal circles.
The microphone one. I did my thesis. Interviews about active hermeneutics, and the objective hermeneutics means that look at words, the used words, and in which normal context they are used, and you looked at the actively accompanied, and since I've read that, I'm thinking, how do you use, when would I use actively accompanied? And I only can think of two ways, and one is in looking after disabled or old people and accompany them, and the other is about paternalistic, really look after someone, and you also talked about hermeneutics, and I'm interested in what you think is meant by that word, and how you could use that word, and how the different authors of this document, what they mean by this.
Das ist, also ich lass mich jetzt mal so weit treiben.
Okay, I go that far that to say I'm very careful right now. It's neoliberalism standing behind that, behind these words.
So
it's happening in the economy.
Der Staat wird hier eben als jemand gesehen oder als einer, der
sich am besten regarded as someone who's not actually acting but only accompanying, looking that the frame is okay, but the state is not expected to act.
Das kann man dadurch erhärten, dass eben auch viele andere Hinweise in diese Richtung gehen.
You can still make this suspicion a bit stronger by looking closer at the tax and finding some other evidence for that. So Gabriel talks about the IT top meeting.
Ins Gespräch kommt mit der Wirtschaft.
So this is the reason for the government getting in touch with the economy. Not with the society. So this strongly directs in the direction of neoliberalism. But the state is not expected to do something. The state should only give you the frame set.
Something from the Signal Angels?
Ja, eine haben wir noch.
We have one more. And how can you prevent the federal government from using such phrases? Are there any strategies how to achieve that?
I didn't see where it came from. It came from the internet.
Aus der Wolke.
It came out of the cloud.
Also man könnte ein bisschen Einfluss drauf nehmen.
So you could get some influence.
Indem halt tatsächlich aufgezeigt wird, dass diese Art,
that this way to express is not being welcomed. You can do it by showing at it.
Es gibt aber natürlich Journalisten.
But there are journalists who can make this public. But if you read the press coverage of the digital agenda, you will see that
die Formulierung übernommen werden.
That these phrases are simply being copied by the press, by the media. So they are simply quoted. So people, journalists simply take over these quotations. So they use the same vocabulary and so it's working actually. My wish is that this way of, well, quoting wouldn't work any longer that well.
Was kann man natürlich auch durch, weiß ich nicht, Massenproteste oder sonst was.
So you can have mass protests, but well,
wenn man halt eine Gegenöffentlichkeit schafft.
But you simply could start having a counter publicity. So people like me,
wird sich da auch eine Veränderung einstellen.
So if people like me would do that, maybe there would be a change.
Okay, microphones. Dobrit talked about exact numbers that they would have in October. Did they mean this October or next October? Oh, when, which
exactly?
Unklar.
And
in addition, the new frequencies shall be used starting 2017 or 2018. And so the digital agenda talks about, doesn't talk about a long time.
Exactly. The digital agenda will go until 2017, but they will always say that the market-driven expansion should be complete by 2018. Sometimes they talk about October and autumn in the digital agenda. So, but it's unclear which autumn they actually mean. Maybe they mean next year.
Sonst ist es sinnlos, sonst hat man die Zahlen nicht.
Because they have to do a first evaluation, but they wouldn't have the right figures before that. But so it's quite plausible that they are talking about autumn 2015. Then they know how much money is left in the fund. Then they can split up the money, the government can split up the money, then they will start. And maybe they will be done with the expansion until 2018, by 2018, sorry. But maybe these figures won't be relevant by 2018 any longer.
Okay, microphone 3. And I ask myself, if I look at this, there are different formattings, different justification or different phrases in the document. And if I look at Dobrindt, who just talks garbage, and how is the balance between just technical incompetence and just misguidance, being misguided that the government seems to be suffering from?
I think if
Dobrindt is talking freely, but maybe it's a personal error of him, so it's no attention behind.
FIFA hat mich gestern darauf hingewiesen, dass man den Dobrindt ganz selten sieht. Das stimmt auch.
FIFA hat yesterday pointed out that Dobrindt is seen rather seldomly. So there are only few public statements from Dobrindt. So maybe his ministry is not regarded as that important.
Ich glaube, bestimmte Dinge sind
beabsichtigt. Some things are intended and have been planned on a long schedule. So the payment of the financing of that, so it has been planned on a long schedule. It's quite fits well with the current finance politics and cutting off of debts. So you aren't expected to spend money. So you have to find a mechanism to get things paid. And before you can spend some money, you have to first earn it. So there seems to be some planning behind.
Der Text der digitalen Agenda ist natürlich vor allen Dingen auch von Fachkräften in Anführungszeichen
and geschrieben. The text of the digital agenda has been written by specialists. So Gabriel Dobrindt and de Maizière hasn't written this text actually. But it has been written by people who are very close to the material. So in this context we cannot expect this to be a personal failure.
Im Moment geschehen. Während die ersten Statements, die wir gehört haben, das war wiederum vorbereitet.
So the first statements you heard were prepared. So the failure of Dobrindt, de Maizière, was his personal error, but the statements before have been planned. So I would look at the text of the digital agenda, planned on long schedule.
Wenn da irgendwas drin steht, ist das auch bewusst so gemeint.
So if you find something in there, it is intended. And even these phrases, these buzzwords, are there by intention.
Okay. Dear Martin, you dissected that very nicely and gave the hint at the end that the thoughts of the neoliberalism is that the state doesn't do anything. It's like a night watch. But if you try to with the means of a language, with discussion and talk and counter-talk, and we dissect the digital agenda there, and we get the replies in exactly this kind of language, and it's like trying to nail a putting to the wall. And do you have any advice for a hapless member of parliament or delegate, how to handle that?
Ja, vielleicht sollte man auch ins Arsenal der Sprache greifen und sich eben dann auch griffige
get some tools from the arsenal of speech and find to some provocative phrases. I suggested this a couple of times. So for example, you can replace finance model by gambling. And you have if you have a good phrase, you can be sure that the media will take over this phrase. So you can change things by having by coining some phrases.
I've never seen that people have been persuaded in parliament. He said, oh, he's right, and so we have to think about that. That doesn't happen in a parliamentary discussion. That's just, but you have to make up very catchy phrases that you can get to the media, like the game of the digital dividend. And then if you talk about that in a ridiculous way, then instead, and you need catchy phrases to counter that. And the other side will say, oh, they exaggerate and it's populism and polemics, but they have to do something about it. And maybe that's a way where you can do that, but not for the parliament. There is no solution for parliament, but to carry it into the public, and then things will change in parliament.
Eine allerletzte Frage noch. Mikro 1, bitte.
One very last question.
Let's talk about the formulations again, the phrasing again, and there's a, the ministries were involved there, I think, and there were people who weren't really experts, and there's a text that really has been watered down in the end, and even if there were concrete demands, and it is watered down when it is edited in the ministry. And the wording, I really found myself in many of these things that which you talked about, and these empty words, and people, you really get into it, and one coworker always writes proactive, and then everyone suddenly starts writing proactively shaping, and I've seen that, and it's really a vicious circle, and it's not very particular to the digital agenda. But the main thing I think is that the budget hadn't been ratified, and you really talked about that correctly. And there still is, internet is still a new country, and we go by small steps, but we have to do something about it, but there's no money that we can spend there. And I really like how you talked about that very, very clearly. But I would really go beyond that and make a call. And the reason is really they really don't know how they would spend the money, and they really don't know how to improve things. And what the flowery phrase of a far goal is, now we do this and that and that and that, and do small steps, and whoever has good ideas for small steps and write it down. And if you can then really talk about how much it's going to cost, you can easily get it into the budget.
Also zum ersten Punkt kann ich aber was sagen, das ist in der Tat so, das kann man auch selber
nachvollziehen, sie checkt.
Jeder Netzpolitik hat
die Netzpolitik.
Erste Version, die geleakt ist, mit der zweiten Version.
So Netzpolitik compared the first leaked version with the second one. They made a diff about it, over it. And you already see how these formulations become bigger, get more space in the text.
And
so it's rather interesting to do that. I didn't do that because Netzpolitik did it before. But you can see the development of these phrases becoming bigger, taking more space. You can do some work on it and compare all the versions, and you will see this development of these phrases becoming bigger.
Bei der letzten Änderung, die ich aufgezeigt habe, sieht man ja,
if you look at the last change that I showed you, you can see that someone wrote something additionally, maybe in order to cushion some expectations.
Es gibt da so eine gewisse Hilflosigkeit und tatsächlich.
They are a bit helpless.
Der CCC ist auch ein Lobbyverband.
So the CCC is also a lobby organization, and
beraten tätig werden, und das muss
so
auch,
we can work as consultants for politicians.
Also es müssen ja auch noch andere beraten, das ist
but
ganz klar.
If we are the only ones, it's not enough, so others have to do this job as well.
Ja.